So I'm doing an IoT design, and it's got some sensors, of course, and it's got a camera, of course, and I need to do a lot of computing work right in my device. No shipping stuff back and forth to the cloud. That means I need a lot of processing power for the software I'm writing, because some of it will be in real time. I also need an FPGA for the custom logic and interface part, and maybe for some of the acceleration too. And that doesn't even get me started with the security and reliability concerns I've got. Sheesh. Wouldn't it be cool if there was one chip that could do all of that and fit in my very tight power budget? Well, there is. Hi there, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. Today, my guest is KK Ramaruthi from Microchip Technology, and we're going to talk about the new PolarFire SoC, an FPGA with built-in RISC-V processors that's low power, high reliability, and high security. Let's go. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about the PolarFire SoC from Microchip Technology. Welcome, KK. Thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks, Amelia. Happy to be here.
So we've had PolarFire FPGAs for a couple years now, and I'm excited to talk about this new PolarFire SoC. But before we dive into the details of that, can you tell me about the trends you've been seeing in the IoT computing arena?
Absolutely. The advent of Internet of Things is leading to an exponential growth of connected devices throughout the world. These edge node devices connect to transport devices or gateways, and those in turn connect to data centers or cloud where a lot of the analytics are done. Typically, these edge nodes are smaller, power constrained, with little or no intelligence. But now, we see the IoT evolving and see a trend where a lot more is expected out of these edge and gateway devices. They now need to be more intelligent and in some cases have inference engines built into them.
Yeah, that's certainly a trend we've been seeing as well.
This trend actually poses a few challenges as well. Intelligence at the edge implies that we should have end-to-end security, reliability by design, and low power throughout. That's where Microchip's FPGA and SoC portfolio fits perfectly, in the edge and gateway applications with our low power, highly secure, and reliable products.
And I can see that mid-range FPGAs like PolarFire really fit well into that story.
Exactly. We at Microchip focus on these markets, the edge and gateway devices, with our mid-range SoC and FPGA portfolio. Our portfolio offers cost and power-optimized SoCs and FPGAs, while also offering high data rate transceivers that match perfectly to the evolving trend of intelligence at the mid to low-end IoT world. This is exactly where PolarFire SoC would also fit in perfectly.
It seems like the low power, high reliability, and the security features that you guys have always had with your FPGAs are quite unique in this space.
Oh, absolutely. Microchip's SoC and FPGA portfolio solves problems that no one else can. We offer products that are lowest power consuming, extremely reliable, and highly secure. For instance, applications such as thermal and power-constrained imaging, portable communications, and in remotely deployed edge devices, low power is a critical requirement, and our portfolio fits in perfectly. Our decades of experience in space, aviation, safety-critical, and communications infrastructure applications help us in making products that offer highly reliable solutions for their problems. We also provide for the highest security requirements for communications, embedded radar applications, and tamper and theft-proof commercial systems.
Okay, now let's talk specifically about some of the application areas that can take advantage of that.
Sure. We enable purpose-built, real-time, low-power systems. For example, these could be safety-critical systems, imaging and machine learning applications, robotics, smart weapons, drones, and UAVs, industrial IoT, and networked battlefield applications.
Cool. Now let's dive into some of that fun part. Well, for me at least. I assume the SoC in the name, there are processors on these FPGAs, and that you've chosen RISC-V. So tell me a little bit more why you guys chose RISC-V.
Oh, I'll ask you, why not RISC-V? RISC-V is free and an open ISA. It enables us to create a clean slate design that is simple, stable, modular, and expandable. Not just that, the RISC-V's ecosystem is growing exponentially. RISC-V extends Moore's Law. It gives us a free architectural license and gives us a free hand to innovate as per our own needs.
Okay.
So what we did with all this freedom was to enable mixed criticality systems.
So what do you mean by that?
So what you can do with PolarFire SoC is that you could turn off the CPU branch predictors. You can configure the L1 instruction cache to work as a tightly integrated memory. Configure the L2 memory system to provide determinism. Make sure all cores are cache coherent. And with that, you can achieve absolute determinism.
Okay, cool. So you've given me the kind of determinism features that I need for my real-time tasks, as well as having something that I can handle for the more high-level applications as well. So what else is going on with PolarFire SoC, and what can it do for me?
PolarFire SoC is truly an innovation platform. We've taken our award-winning PolarFire FPGA architecture, and with the help of our partners Sci5 and UltraSoC, we added 5 RISC-V cores with cache coherency, a large L2 memory subsystem, advanced secure boot capabilities. Users can use it in Linux and real-time applications, thermal and power-constrained applications, security and mixed critical systems.
Wow, 5 cores. I could do a lot with that. Now, power consumption is always a key constraint in my designs, and it's something that you guys have always been good at. So tell me more about the low power picture for PolarFire SoCs.
Sure. So we did some benchmarks on PolarFire SoC. What you see here is exactly that. The 95K logic element PolarFire SoC, for instance, offers up to 50% lower power. The chart here shows PolarFire SoC alongside our competitors with dual-core Cortex-A9s and dual-core Cortex-A53s. This is a chart showing core marks per watt. You'd notice that at 1.3 watts, PolarFire SoC delivers up to 6,500 core marks, while our competing SoCs with dual-core Cortex-A9s and A53s don't even have enough power to start their booting process. This enables significant thermal and power-constrained applications.
Wow, that's a significant power savings. Now, security has become a big deal in all IoT designs. And it's not just defense anymore, right?
Yes, that's exactly right. We used our experience in defense applications to provide the same level of security features to the IoT world. PolarFire SoC inherits its best-in-class PolarFire FPGA security. You get DPA-resistant bitstream programming, anti-tamper features, cryptographically bound supply chain assurance. We also have a PUF, physically unclonable function, true random number generator, and side-channel-resistant crypto core processor. Along with these, PolarFire SoC adds standard secure boot and user-defined secure boot. It's inherently Spectre and Meltdown immune. We had physical memory protection, which is part of the RISC-V specification. We also add SecDead, single error correction, double error detection on all MSS memories.
Okay, cool. So you guys have a history of making FPGAs for space use. And that makes me think you know a thing or two about reliability.
That's right. With PolarFire SoC, you get zero failure in time, single event upset, neutron immune FPGA configurations. Not just that, all the microprocessor subsystem memories are SecDead protected. They sense errors and generate exceptions that can be routed to the fabric for hardware response as well.
Now, once you have an SoC, not just a regular FPGA, that creates the need for a whole environment for software development and debugging. What's the software development ecosystem for RISC-V?
That's a good question. What we did at Microchip was to create what we call the MiFi ecosystem. It's Microchip's initiative towards creating an ecosystem around RISC-V and PolarFire SoC-based application. The MiFi ecosystem consists of development tool vendors. So we have IAR, Ada Core, and of course, the GCC.
Okay.
And then we have open source 64-bit RTOS vendors such as Amazon FreeRTOS and Zephyr. We also have commercial real-time operating system vendors such as Mentor, Wind River's VXWorks, Express Logic, StradX, and Micrium. That overall covers over 90% of the RTOS market space.
And what about high-level operating systems for my applications?
Yeah, we support Linux. We support both the Octo Project and Buildroot. That essentially covers over 99% of the market.
It sounds like there are a lot of players in the MiFi ecosystem.
That is correct. The MiFi ecosystem consists of companies that offer tools, middlewares, security solutions, hardware and software IP vendors, design houses, and system-on-module vendors, providing end-to-end support for all our customers.
It sounds like my software and debugging needs will be taken care of pretty well. Now, let's dive in and talk about the PolarFire SoC family itself.
Sure. This is a snapshot of PolarFire SoC family. We offer fabric densities from 23K logic elements to 461K, all of them having quad-core Linux-capable RISC-V processor and a monitor core. We have 12.7 gig transceivers with up to 20 lanes. We also offer the smallest form factors, starting from 11 by 11 FCSG 325 package, going all the way to a 35 by 35 FCG 1152 package. We offer devices in extended commercial and industrial temperature ranges for all the die package combinations. And we also offer a few in the military temperature grades.
Okay, so it looks like I'll be able to find a device that is a good match of the right features that I need for my next design. When can I get one of these?
We announced an early access program on 10th of December 2019. We also released Libero 12.3 and Soft Console 6.2 for bare metal designs with Renode. Qualified customers can get access to Libero if they write to PolarFireSoC@microchip.com. Our engineering silicon is scheduled to be available by calendar Q3 2020.
Okay, I'm intrigued by this Renode idea. What can I start with if I want to get going today?
You can download the free embedded development environment Soft Console, which comes bundled with Renode today. It comes with a model for PolarFire SoC, so you can write your firmware on the Soft Console development environment and debug on a model of the PolarFire SoC. We are running a monthly webinar series, and you can watch the webinars to learn more about Soft Console and Renode.
Cool, I'll check those out. And what do you have for me as far as development kits go?
So we're working on a kit called the Icicle Kit for PolarFire SoC. It's going to be a low-cost kit. As of today, we have schematics, Gerbers, and board design guidelines available for this kit. As we go along 2020, we will release more and more information about this kit.
Great. I'm going to click on that link now and go get more information on PolarFire SoCs. So, KK, let's recap what we've talked about today.
Sure. PolarFire SoC inherits features from the PolarFire FPGA architecture. It has award-winning features such as 30 to 50% lower power, defense-grade security, exceptional reliability, and smallest form factors. Now we've added a microprocessor subsystem that's Linux and real-time capable in a deterministic, coherent CPU cluster. That too adds 30 to 50% lower power, defense-grade secure boot, inherently Spectre and Meltdown immune, and sectored on all memories.
That's exciting, and I can't wait to get my hands on a PolarFire SoC and see what I can make with it. Thank you so much for joining me, KK. It was a pleasure speaking with you.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about Microchip Technologies' PolarFire SoC. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talk section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/eejournal.